discuss that because of what might be a septic problem on that side, that we requested that we be hooked up to the sewers when they run the sewers to their projects. And they seem to think there was a problem to run those sewers up our street, something out. I do want to correct something, though, I'm not clear on what you're saying. It wouldn't be the fire vehicles, at least not our understanding, cutting across where our septic is, which is right close to our building. There's a gravel road now that's on the far end of that septic system. And we thought that they would come up there, make a right on Sally Street, cut on an angle for the woods.
Sweeper. You swear the testimony you're about to give, Mr. Adler, shall the truth be told?
I do.
Chairman, what's your name? Can't hear, you gotta speak close to the death hall, really close.
Chairman, vice chairman, I have a proposal, a new proposal that might consider. Originally heard on the radio, Tom Gerber is on the same call we are. And making up an excerpt suggestion to, instead of filling this crap, use foreclosure homes to put these people in. If you watch, you would have to do it. Banks would love to get rid of these properties. And these people eventually gave up on their own homes.
I believe that you walked out, I don't believe you called. You said you accepted that, and we were here. And still they're requiring you to go around three, that we put out around three plans, and then by December 31st, so it's, I'm not saying it's bad, but it's wrong. I kind of agree with you, but regulations don't accept that yet. I think it's on the, at the thought. And the code regulations around three, they want by December 31st, I think it's fair. The town has to complete plan together, show that we can meet our obligations by December 31st. I hear you, sir. I hear you. Yeah, that's the public, I know, please come on.
Hi, Erica Piper, 70 Greenville Road.
Erica, can you spell your last name?
V-E-I-C-H-E-R-T.
Okay, you ready, Erica? You swear the testimony you're about to give, Mr. Adler, shall the truth be told?
Yes. I just need to ask a question. I'm a little bit confused about something. You have a planning board member, if I'm correct, who is, has recused himself since the start of this application. He's also a member of the Italian Garden Club, is that correct?
Correct.
We haven't heard any testimony from the Italian Garden Club up until tonight, as far as I remember, is that correct?
That's what we're going to address.
I'm just curious, so conveniently, all of a sudden now, the Italian Garden Club of this project goes through, might be able to tap into a sewer system?
The gentleman said, should we talk, yeah.
Is that a done deal?
As far as how we are extending our sewer line, it would provide, as it happens, a more convenient place. Any other suggestion other than that's a coincidence? I don't have any questions about basically the bona fide.
If I'm not mistaken, any of that would have to be approved by the MUA also.
Without that.
Not to go through the MUA, it just can't be a handshake.
Okay, that mentioned it. When did this idea even surface?
First.
And the only person who heard about the town guard that would be concerned about this project, why for months, we've had the residents of Army Farms and the surrounding community come up to this mic and share their concern. And now we're supposed to play nice. There's just something really wrong here with this whole situation, and the deal that we need to time close to us. And that's all I want to say about
second meeting that came to. club had asked me, and they couldn't, I didn't even know what was going on with the police, until they asked me to represent them. But the goal was, I'm not a member. The goal was, I'm just a member of the club. The goal was to try and shut this project down, to try and fight it. We reached out to a couple of attorneys, some of the members of the club did, and we were told that too much water was over the dam, and better off addressing their concerns. We didn't do that, we did not have a conversation with them until this week, because they approached us about access with this emergency road. There was absolutely no side deal, there is no side deal. We addressed concerns, we opposed this project from the beginning, we oppose it now. I don't want it as a Jackson resident, I don't want it as a Jackson homeowner, I don't want it for my children, I don't want it as a member of the Italian American Club. But if it goes through, we ought to control the way it looks, so that we can be comfortable with it. And that's our position, so I just want to feel like if anyone wants to come and talk to us about it, we'd be happy to. One of the things that we tossed around in the club was, let's hold a tent service there, get everyone in town to come in and throw money into a bucket to hire an attorney if it shut this project down the crack. And we were advised that that's never going to happen. It's done. So whatever deals were made behind closed doors were made well before we got here or any of these meetings. Testimony implies, and he found in the records that something just didn't match. I mean, this is not something that we want, and we spoke with our neighbors. We tried to get new neighbors, we spoke with them about it. They were there to meet the attorney this week for the first time, okay? Reviewed the property, reviewed what these concerns are. We're not happy about it. I don't want it. I wish I ever did. So I'll be perfectly clear on that. We are not endorsing this project. We don't want it. We don't have a side deal. But we do have concerns. There are public safety measures. We're trying to be a good neighbor. And if you think that anything that may be agreed to get done isn't in the best interest of the township overall, and just think it's in the best interest of the club, then please address that with us, because we don't want that image in this town where we do a lot of good work.
Yes, I could address one thing that was said. And maybe I take offense to it, and maybe my fellow board members feel the same way. Any complaint or any of that back room deal were made or any report, another one might have come up and make the allegation. There's nothing been back in this board. Since I've been on this board with 12 members, nothing has ever been done. And I think I've assured the public of that, and I think we've kind of proved that. And I do take offense if we're included in that conversation, but I don't like to hear it. And nobody on this board has an approach that I know of. No one has talked about it. Matter of fact, I'm the one with a pain in the ass because I don't want my board speaking about applications outside like they're not supposed to. And we really stick to that. And that's how this board has been ran for 3 years, not by my doing. And the general consensus of the members of this board, one of the best paid boards in 37 years I've ever seen in this town, not the law of the land use ever been in this town. I have to say, remember this board here, this is one of the most professional and refined. But the professional land use, we all come from different sectors of life, from people who work in the state, and retired teachers and engineers, and all the nuclear plants, which are very nice is a complete mix. And I just want to rest assured that Paul was somehow in this way. There's been no backroom deal. We brought here the applications. The only closed session we had ever since we've been here for the last 3 years is when we decided on professionals and hiring a professional. We went to closed sessions and there's been no other closed sessions before the middle of the 5 weeks on this application and the other. I just want to get that paper back. Go ahead.
I swear the judge about to give this letter show which is up to you now.
My concern, my property backs up to a dirt road in front of the Italian American Club. And behind my property is a substation. I don't know if it's JCPM or GPU or BPU. We have enough kids hanging there. There's dirt road, they drive through, they hang out. They just do what teenagers do. My concern is, sometimes it's a jungle gym. What's going to happen when these children, it's got to be about 100 yards to 150 yards in front of the Italian American Club. I'd be very concerned with children being that close to that high of voltage. I've seen turkey gobblers flying there, catch on fire, start brush fires, call the police, we call the fire department, and we call the police, and usually when there's just kids being hit, by the time the cops come, the kids are gone, because they cut through, go to garbage can, call the video, whatever. And actually, if I can be there, you can walk on time and run. But they're all children. They're preteens, teenagers, maybe even, you know, 19, 20-year-olds. When you're putting in younger children, which normally seem to come with this type of a development, I would be very concerned for those children.
Yes, for the very good reason, questions from Brandon and Brenda. You swear the test you're about to give this final showing the truth that you got.
Yes, I do. Mr. Bradley and Council, I agree with your opinion on the integrity of your council. I think a lot of people are a little worried with maybe the county level and the state level. And I think that's what people are referring to maybe as the back door deal. Because being that this project comes east out of the county through the state, there's a lot of political and financial repercussions for the project not to be approved in Jackson. Now, not that I've done a lot of research on this, but I've been at several meetings. I've been listening. I am a Harmony Farms owner of the property. It's from my view, it's apparent that this was a very hastily put together plan to develop this project. And the reason I say that is because that the council for the developers so ready to be amenable to what the planning board suggests that they do to make things better. I don't understand why they didn't make themselves known to the community at hand that's here sitting today, so that a lot of this wouldn't even be going on if they had come and presented the project with some care and concern for the neighborhood and for the neighboring affiliations, such as the Italian American Club. My property is adjacent to the Inuit easement. And I have the same concerns that a representative from the Italian American Club presented. We have, I don't know how many calls I've had to make in, and not saying that it's coming out of this project, but I'm saying in lieu of Jackson being such a large township and the financial burdens to police such a large township, it's hard for Jackson to do. I don't know how many calls I have into the police department about vagrancy with the teenagers hanging. I've been finding all sorts of homemade type of pipes down the easement. They're burning 5-foot, 10-foot sections. And the police simply can't respond in a timely manner. And I understand that there's more critical and more, you know, pertinent concerns to address than some teenagers doing illegal activities